I can say that cycling at the international level started in 2009. Mm-hmm. Before we were organizing just the local races with no techniques in racing at the national territory. But since then, 2009, we started to organize a tour of Rwanda at the international calendar, registered at International Cycling Union calendar. When we started, we were very, very weak compared to other countries that were invited, like Morocco, Eritrea, and many others. So I can say that since then, we started to learn, from their experience, also from the team that were at the direction of our national team.
Right.
We had, I think you know them, Team Rwanda were directed by the American first racer in Tour de France, Jonathan Boyer. So we started to learn more and more with the organizing of the Tour of Rwanda every year. We start to raise our level every year, and every year since 2009 to 2014, when we won for the first time the Tour of Rwanda, and the president congratulated the team, and also gave the new brand new bikes. Also, he gave us the training center in Musanze. So since then, we didn't lose any to
Rwanda. Look back. And so probably looking at that particular journey itself, today we are talking about Rwanda seemingly wanting to position itself as one of the cycling powerhouses. We've seen Areruya, who's actually just about 23, heading to 24, winning major you know, races. So looking at this, how is Rwanda now positioning itself to look beyond just the attractions that we have here, the gorillas and, you know, the conference tourism, plugging the cycling, you know, sport as yes. one of the frontiers that would also attract investment in the country. How are you doing this?
I can say that Rwanda is looked as first cycling country in Africa in competing and also in organizing big races like Tour of Rwanda. Tour of Rwanda has become the famous cycling race in Africa. So also we plan to ahead to continue to raise the Tour of Rwanda from 2.2 last year to 2.1. So it will be the best race in Africa at the level of competition, also of the popularity. So beyond that, we are solicited by the International Cycling Union also to organize the World Championship in 2025. Mm-hmm. The World Championship, it's the most big race that is organized by the like the World Cup for football or other big race big events, sports events that can bring many tourists, many people that will bring money in the country.
Right, and so this calls for investments. And of course, I would like to hear from you what sort of investments in terms of numbers, in terms of strategies are being put in place already for Rwanda to actually meet all this, you know, expectations that will come with this, you know, responsibilities.
So we have started to invest in clubs, to help clubs to find sponsors, also to help them to find new talents, young talents, and it's an activity that is being done now, and I can say that now we have a big, very, very big number of young people who want to practice cycling. So we are looking for some tools, some materials to give them. And I think it is very promising for the future of cycling.
This you speak to the, you know, the participants. But now let's talk about the corporate world. How much of an appetite do you think the success of the cycling sport is actually creating for investment into this particular sporting event? What are the opportunities? If someone is watching us now and they have the money, where are the opportunities? Where can they plug in?
There is a big opportunity in cycling. Mm-hmm. As you know, Tour of Rwanda is the most sponsored event in Rwanda. Many big companies are on board to sponsor the event. I think we started by 100% from the government, but now we are at 30% of the budget from the government. So the private sector has come inside.
To sponsor 70%.
Yes, 70%, because the tour, it's a tour of the whole country, and it gives the opportunity for the investors, for the business community to advertise, to reach so many people that they can't reach with the sports that are practiced in the stadiums.
Right. So the corporate companies that are not part of Tour de Rwanda, part of the cycling sport, I'm talking about those who haven't, because I'm sure it is
yes,
not all
yes,
the same.
Yes.
What sort of message would you be telling them? What are they missing out on?
I tell them that they continue, because it's a successful sport that the population like Tour of Rwanda, because it's a sport that also Rwandans win. So that is attracting many people to come and watch.
I want to jump onto this incentive that was announced by the Minister of Finance during the budget reading session, where the 25% levy that was imposed on imported sports bicycles was actually waived. I want to hear your thoughts on where you see this supporting the cycling sports in Rwanda.
Yeah, as a sport, cycling is very expensive. You know, one bike can cost $10,000, so it's very expensive. And with the removal of the taxes, it will help us to give it to as many as possible without taxes. You know, we have a big number of practitioners, and also those who want to practice sports like you and other people. It will help them to practice for their health.
For their health. And so probably looking forward, apart from this incentive of the waiver of the 25% levy, what more do you want so that you can be able to deliver this mandate that you have right now as the president of the Cycling Federation?
Okay, what more I want is to continue support like the government does, but also I invite them to support the clubs, because there are those clubs in different corner of the country that help us to look for those young talents and to raise them to be good riders.
So when we'll be meeting again to have this conversation of Rwanda's bold steps to becoming a cycling powerhouse, what will you be recording, or what will you be reporting back? What will you be telling us that you'll have already achieved, sort of telling us a way ahead of the expectations?
The way ahead is to continue to train as many as possible, and also now we are at the fourth position in Africa. Also to continue to raise our sports to the international level, like in Europe, and to go to Tour de France.
Right, Tour de France is where you're heading.
Yes.
That's where you want. Now, maybe the biggest stumbling blocks in this, because all the sporting federations have had their own challenges back door, you know, where we are seeing some in the public. What is the biggest challenge to you or for you today as a cycling sport in the country?
The big challenge we have is that the bicycles are very, very expensive, and also our clubs are still poor.
Right, they're poor in terms of being able to manage themselves.
Money to find sponsors. So we have to look left and right to help them, but I hope that maybe in the future they will find sponsors that will help too.
But there's been this push for Made in Rwanda, and there are people who have been exhibiting some of the Made in Rwanda bikes made out of bamboos and all that.
I saw it.
Top quality, is this something you can rely on? And you say we put aside the 10,000 worth of those bicycles we import and we go for this one. Is this something that you
That is for leisure, for people who are not competing with others. It can be used for people who want to just for sport and just for leisure, not for competition.
They're not yet to the standards of competition.
No.
All right. Thank you so much for
making
time to speak to us today.
Thank you.
On CNBC Africa. Thank you very much. That is